Hello, my name is Ashley Chen, and I'm here to talk about how I learned to stop worrying and love burn rates. First and foremost, I am a software engineer at Datadog, where I am part of the SLO app team. My team builds the infrastructure that allows users to create SLOs for their services. Some of the things that I work on include building services that query data for their SLIs, indexing SLO statuses, and evaluating SLO alerts. Like any other engineering team, we have an on-call rotation for when things are broken. For example, if our users are unable to query for their SLOs, use the UI, or get alerted for their error budget and burn rates, we will get paged and I get to investigate the issue. And like any other engineering team, there are common drawbacks to parts of the reliability aspect of the team. We often get flaky alerts where monitors may auto-resolve after triggering for a few minutes. We also get runbooks that may be too generalized for the monitor that it's associated to. And lastly, and most importantly, we're not always sure what the customer impact looks like for a given page that gets triggered. So, as the SLO team, we're in a place where we have the opportunity to try out some of the best practices that come with implementing SLOs. One of the questions we had was, what if we replace threshold alerts with burn rate alerts? Let me explain. Simple threshold alerts are simply a monitor that triggers based on a value. You can think of it as an error rate monitor. In this example, we have an alert that triggers when it exceeds 5% in error rate and resolves when it goes back to less than 5%. Burn rate alert is a little bit more complex and also requires an SLO. To calculate the burn rate, you divide the error rate over the error budget. In this example, we have a burn rate alert that triggers at a burn rate of 14.4. So what does that mean and what does that represent? Well, at a high level, it represents how fast the error budget is burning. Remember, it's the ratio of the error rate over the error budget. And an error budget is just a budget that you have before your SLO is breached. So in this case, we have an example of an SLO with a target of 95%. And in this case, the error budget for this SLO would be 5%. To understand burn rates even more, here's a graph that shows the outcome of each burn rate. A burn rate of 1, which is represented in the blue line, means that a gradual burn of the error budget is expressed. And a burn rate of 10, which is represented with the red line, means that it is a fast burn of your error budget. The bigger the burn rate, the faster the error budget is burning, and ultimately the bigger the impact is on your services. This is a very high level explanation of burn rate alerts, so I recommend reading the Google SRE book, specifically chapter 5, or watching some of the other talks here at the SLO conference. In comparison, simple threshold alerts are much easier for humans to understand. They are useful at catching specific issues, but compared to burn rate alerts, simple threshold alerts cannot capture long-term trends. Burn rate alerts, on the other hand, can take historical errors into account and can detect slow, gradual changes. On the downside, they are a little bit more complex to set up and configure. So, as a question to my experiment that I'm about to conduct, is whether or not burn rate alerts would actually make on-call more manageable. Now, there are a lot of literature and resources out there that tells you, yes, this is the case, and yes, there are mathematical ways that you can figure out what your burn rates are, but my team wanted to figure out how we can put burn rates into practice and how feasible it is to replace a production-ready threshold alert with a burn rate alert. So in our experiment, we decided to pick an existing monitor, which is a simple threshold alert that triggers on one of our services' error rates. We then created an SLO and a target that we believe reflects the impact of this existing monitor that we have picked. We then created multiple burn rate alerts that uses the multi-window method that is described in the Google SRE book. Specifically, we created three alerts, one that uses a slow burn rate, a moderate burn rate, and a fast burn rate. We then waited 6 months for these alerts to get triggered. And then we took all of these pages and categorized them by what initially caused these pages, what kind of manual action was taken, the duration of the problem, and also which burn rate alert fired at the same time as the simple threshold alert. So here is a breakdown of our results and findings. In 6 months, we were paged 33 times by the simple threshold alert. 17 of them were flaky and 16 of them had manual actions taken. And here is a breakdown of what alerts were triggered. In this case, the simple threshold alert is our control. It should also be noted that when the fast burn rate triggered, the slow and moderate burn rate also triggered. A good thing that we can see here is that all burn rate alerts did not trigger on most flaky alerts. There's also an interesting spread of pages across different burn rates. So let's take a look at that. The way that we had classified each of our page are by these four categories. The known incident is whenever we got a page and we were informed that there was an ongoing incident with an upstream service. A dependency scale-up page meant that we investigated the problem and the action that was taken was either scaling up one of our dependencies or creating our own incident, informing our dependency that they needed to scale up. Our third category is unknown, which meant that there was some kind of manual action taken, but ultimately the root cause of it is unknown. Lastly, we have our flaky pages, which obviously means that the alert auto-resolved after a few minutes and no action was taken. So just taking a look at the pages that included manual action, we can see that majority of the pages were from known incidents. This table shows that burn rates triggered on most of the actionable pages. We also see that when there is a known incident, our high burn rate was triggered. On dependency scale-ups and unknown pages, the slow and moderate burn rates were triggered. So from running this experiment, we found out that burn rate alerts did not trigger on most flaky pages, which is a really good and promising result that we found. Secondly, each burn rate alert showed a different level of urgency as seen on the previous slide. And thirdly, burn rate alerts grouped multiple pages. What I mean by that is that during our experiment, our simple threshold alert would page consecutively while our burn rate alert would only page once. So this is all good news because if we had used just our burn rate alerts and not our simple threshold alerts, we could have reduced our pages by 42% in the past 6 months. So even though this is promising results, I like to remind us that burn rate alerts aren't necessarily replacements for threshold alerts. In many cases, they are not, and burn rates are only as good as your SLOs, which means on my team, in order to use burn rate alerts effectively, we need to continue discussing our SLOs and in our page reviews and reliability reports. That is the only way that we can make our alerts and on-call experience more meaningful. So thank you for attending my talk. As a reward, here is a picture of my dog sleeping in serenity, which is how I like to sleep at night, aka not getting woken up by pages. Thank you.